Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Zubah. Today we are going to discuss in a very debatable topic, that is law pertaining to live-in relationship. Now this is why debatable, because whenever any discussion in the society or in the family or in the job, anywhere, there are two categories. One is in the favor of live-in relationship and another one is not in the favor of live-in relationship. And they are also having any discussion that this is considered as illegal, that is immoral, that is not, it is not acceptable by the society, so it won't happen. And on the other hand, the other category say that it is necessary to be in any sort of relationship which you want, and it is the right of any person to live in whatever way, in whatever form they want to live, and they want a stress-free life. So whether live-in relationship is actually a stress-free, whether you think that living in live-in relationship won't have any liability, won't have any legality, you are wrong. If you are living in any relationship, no matter it is after marriage or you are living in a live-in relationship, still you are having a responsibility and liability. So you have to understand that live-in relationship also have certain laws related to it, and it is necessary that you should understand all the laws. Now what are the categories which we are going to discuss under laws pertaining to live-in relationship? The first one is whether it is legalized or whether it is a criminal offense or not. Second thing, what should be the age of live-in relationship? Third thing, about the gender, who can live under live-in relationship. Next thing is related to property, whether there is any right in the property of male. Next is whether there is any right of maintenance for a woman. Another thing is whether there is any right of a child born out of live-in relationship. And then last thing is what are the problems related to live-in relationship. So this will be the area of discussion. Now the first question, whether live-in relationship is criminal offense or not. So let me tell you, now live-in relationship is not anymore a criminal offense. It has been already decided in many cases. There are some leading cases like Payal Katara and Indra Sharma, in which a sufficient guidelines has been given by the Supreme Court. Now as far as criminal offense, it has been already said that if any adult want to live their life in their own way, it cannot be said that it is immoral or illegal. So live-in relationship is no more a criminal offense. Second thing is related to age. That means if it is not a criminal offense, but still there are certain criteria which any person has to follow if they really wants to live under live-in relationship. If you are not following that criteria, then there is no law for you. So you have to understand all the law pertaining to live-in relationship. So first thing is the age of live-in relationship. So the age is, as you all know, that the age of adult in India is 18 years for a girl and 21 years for the boy. So if any girl or boy are adult and they want to live in a live-in relationship, then they must be adult. This is the first criteria. If any boy is living with a girl, no matter he is major, but the girl is not major, she is below the age of 18, then he may be charged for kidnapping also, for sexual abuse also, for rape also, for n number of charges, not only under IPC but also in POXO Act. So you have to be very careful if you are attempting even or thinking even to live in a live-in relationship, that you have to be, that means both the person must be adult as per Indian norms. This is the first criteria to live-in relationship legally. Now the second thing is related to gender or which type of person can live in the live-in relationship. Why we are saying gender, not sex? Because this particular thing is related, is basically a gender sensitive, which has been mentioned under Indra Sharma case. Some of the guidelines has been mentioned. Now, who are the person who can live? First is the one which is most uncomplicated. That is any adult, unmarried male and female can live in a live-in relationship. The second category, a married male and an unmarried female may also live. The third category is married female and unmarried male may also live in the live-in relationship. And the fourth category is anyone who are of same sex can also live in the live-in relationship. That means any gay or lesbian or transgender, anyone can live in the live-in relationship. This category can live in a live-in relationship with the consent of each other and with their own will, voluntarily. They can live in the live-in relationship, so it cannot be considered as a criminal offense. But if we talk about that category in which there is a married woman and unmarried male, whether in that condition, or if there is a married woman and a married male, and if there is any sort of relationship which is a sexual relationship, whether it is a criminal offense? So yes, earlier it was a criminal offense which is called as adultery, which has been mentioned under section 497 of IPC, which states that if any man is having a physical relationship with any married woman, it will be amount as adultery, for which the punishment will be 5 years. Now this particular section has been discussed and omitted now on the ground of some of the articles of constitution, and it has been stated that everyone is having their right to choose, and it is said that under article 14 it is a right to liberty, and at article 15 it has been said that everyone should be treated equally and there should not be any discrimination on the ground of age, sex, gender, everything. So now adultery is no more an offense. So if any man is living with a married woman, it won't be, there won't be any charge of adultery if it is by the consent of that woman, first thing. Second thing is, it is still, that means adultery is still not a criminal offense, but it is still a ground for divorce. That if any married woman is having a sexual relationship with another man, then it is still a ground for divorce. Protection of women from Domestic Violence Act 2005 is first thing, or a first legislation which is in favor of live-in relationship. Because in this particular thing, the definition of domestic relationship is in the favor of not only the women who are married and living in the same roof or under the same roof with a male, but also for all the women who are living under the same roof with any male and they are living for a specific period of time. So this is the first thing which is in favor of live-in relationship. The next very important criteria to avail all the laws related to live-in relationship is significant time period. Now what is the meaning of significant time period, which has been mentioned in the guidelines of the Supreme Court? Now significant time period is basically to show the compatibility and seriousness of the relationship, no matter it is a live-in relationship, to avail all the rights related to live-in relationship, no matter it is a right related to property or maintenance or a child right who is born out of live-in relationship. Now, although it has not been, the time period has not been mentioned in any cases, that what would be the time period which is considered as a significant amount of time. But definitely it should be like that. For example, there is a case in Kerala where after 50 years living in live-in relationship, the couple got married just because of the societal pressure which has been made towards the children and the grandchildren. So for them they get married. So if the couple is living for 50 years in any relationship, no matter they are not married, it is considered that it is a significant time period. But it is not necessary to prove that you have to live for 50 years to prove. It may be 1 year, it may be more than that. But your compatibility must be shown. In which case, it is significant time, but it may be any other time, any other things also. If you are not serious, then it cannot be. If you are living with only for a night or for a day or for a week, a month, a couple of months or 2-4 months, it is not considered as a significant time period. So it is basically an interpretation by the court to prove that there is a seriousness in the relationship and compatibility, and that's why the couple were living in the live-in relationship. That's why they are having a right to avail all the rights related to a property or maintenance, all the child rights. So significant time is very necessary to avail all these laws. This question is whether there is any right to maintenance under live-in relationship. So first of all, we have to understand the definition of maintenance. Maintenance is something when any women or parents or a child are dependent, then the maintenance can be given to them under Hindu law, which is mentioned under Hindu Marriage Act. But as far as maintenance of independent wife is concerned, it is mentioned under Adoption and Maintenance Act. But these law is only related to Hindu person. What happen if they are interreligion or Muslim or any other religion? For them, maintenance has been defined under section 125 of CRPC. So here for live-in relationship also, section 125 of CRPC is provided for the maintenance for any women, for which again there must be a proper interpretation by the court that there is a compatibility, there is a seriousness in the nature of live-in relationship as well, and there is a significant time period has been spent between the couple. Not for a couple who are living only for some of the time period, then there is no maintenance. The next question is whether the female is having a right in the property of the male. Now again, this is very technical question. Again here the significant amount of time period is a criteria to decide the case. If it is a significant time period which she has spent with that person, then there may be, it is not always, that there may be a chance that she may be having a right in the property of a male, but it is only related to a self-acquired property of the male. Now we have already discussed some of the major provisions pertaining to live-in relationship. But the other part, it is also necessary to discuss. Is there any problem? So yes, there are problems. Although it is legally acceptable and it is no more a criminal offense, but yes, you are having some of the moral and societal pressure. That is the one thing. The next thing is you may be having a problem related to any sort of official document. Now what does official document means? If you are applying for a visa, for joint account, for insurance, for any property if you want to take mutually, or any sort of documents which is official in nature, then there is no law related to any live-in relationship person who are not married. So definitely on bank accounts, visa, insurance, you may suffer a problem. Now time to sum up. Now what are the things which is necessary to understand? First of all, live-in relationship is no more a criminal offense. That means it is legalized by the law. Although it is not acceptable mainly in society, and morally it is not acceptable. Second thing, any person who wants to live in relationship, they must be major or adult. Third thing, any person can live in relationship if they are adult. They may be unmarried male and female. Secondly, there may be a married male and unmarried female. Third, it may be a married female and unmarried male. Fourth, it may be any person of same sex, that means gay or lesbian. So they may live in the live-in relationship. Now the third category is there is a right to maintenance for women under section 125 of CRPC if they are living in a specific period or significant time of the compatibility and seriousness of their relationship. Then the next category is there is any right in the property. Then again it is difficult, but yes, there is a right in the property of male if again it is proved that they had been living in a live-in relationship for a significant time period, and it will be only related to self-acquired property. Now the last thing is whether the child born out of live-in relationship is legitimate. So yes, he is a legitimate child and he is also having a right in the property of their parent. That means self-acquired property of parent, not the ancestral property. And lastly, there are some recognition also which has been given in the society of live-in relationship. So this is all about the laws pertaining to live-in relationship in India. Hope you like the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button. You may also follow me on various social media platforms by the name of Law Colloquy. That is, first is Facebook, then Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter by the name of Law Colloquy. And I also have my website, that is priyasapaha.com, popularly known as Law Colloquy. So till the next video, take care, bye bye.